Hi guys, welcome back. My name is Tiffany. In this video, I'm going to show you the tutorial on how to make the shawl I've been teasing you with for the last few weeks. The yarn that I selected was amazing. I knew by looking at it in its skein that it was going to make something gorgeous, and it did. Oh my gosh. This is my very first shawl, and surprise, surprise, the name of the pattern is My First Shawl. But it turned out exactly as I hoped it would. Oh my gosh, it is stunning and so comfortable. Now that I'm doing the tutorial, I can finally use it and just cuddle up with it on the couch. I'm so excited. So the yarn that I used, I think that yarn can really make or break a project. But the yarn that I used was Red Heart Roll With It. I'm not generally a Red Heart fan, but Red Heart has come out with some pretty impressive yarns that have really caught my eye. The color that I used here was Roll With It in Showtime. So that is what this skein of yarn is. The one that I'm going to show you the tutorial with, how to follow the steps to make this gorgeous shawl, that is Roll With It in Theater. So this will be fun. Anyways, you might notice that I'm talking a little softer. I'm actually shooting this video in the evening while I have the kids in bed. I've been learning how to juggle how to work with having the kids full time. So it's the evening, we're gonna be quiet, but it's all gonna be great. Let's go ahead and head right to how to make this. All right, the material that you're gonna be using are three skeins of yarn. I have 389 yards of yarn per skein. You can get away with just using one skein of yarn and making a really short shawl. That's totally fine. Or you can use more than three skeins and make a really large shawl. This is totally personal preference. I just really liked the length with the three skeins. I'm also using a color for the fringe. This is Simply Soft in Red Autumn. The shawl that I showed you in the example, the fringe was made from Harvest Maize, also Simply Soft. All right, you will also need a pair of scissors. You'll need a size I or 5.5 millimeter crochet hook, fabric glue that dries clear and flexible. That way when it dries, it's invisible and not leaving a rock hard spot in the work. That's no good. We use this when we tie in our ends. That way the ends stay put and don't come out. You're also going to need either a tape measure or a ruler for when we're cutting our fringe so you can get the length of the strings exactly how the same size. All right, to begin, we're going to make our slip knot. Okay, we're gonna chain four. One, two, three, four. Slip stitch into that first space. So I will put two yarns on the top, one on the bottom, yarn over, pull through, all the way through. You're going to chain two, one, two. Now you're going to put five double crochets inside that hole that we just created, okay? So yarn over, insert our hook inside that hole, yarn over, pull through, pull through, pull through. Okay, one double crochet, two, three, four, five, chain two, one, two, and then five more double crochets inside that same hole. One, two, three, four, five. Perfect. Okay, chain two, turn your work. So now it's facing this way and I'm facing my work ready to go. Going to double crochet in the back loop only of the first space. So yarn over, look at the top of your work where you see those V's. Going to insert your hook in the back loop, yarn over, pull through, and then double crochet. Going to go ahead and double crochet, one double crochet in the back loop only, all the way to this spot right here, right before the chain two. So yarn over, back loop only, yarn over, back loop only, yarn over, back loop only. Great. Okay, so inside this chain two spot, we're going to put a double crochet. Just stick your needle right in that hole. So double crochet. Now a treble crochet, so yarn over twice on your hook, insert your hook, yarn over. So now you have four loops on your hook. Gonna yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, pull through two, and yarn over, pull through two. Perfect. Chain two. Gonna do another treble crochet. So yarn over twice, insert your hook, yarn over. There will be four loops on your hook. Yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, pull through two. Perfect. Now double crochet inside that hole. Yarn over. Perfect. We are done with that corner spot. Now go ahead and double crochet in the back loops only of the next one, two, three, four. There's going to be five. So four spots. So here we go. Yarn over, back loop, one, yarn over, back loop, two, yarn over, back loop, three, yarn over, back loop, four, but we know we put five in this section. Well, that fifth one is kind of hidden right there, okay? So you might have to separate your stitches a little bit to see. Up, there it is. Also, it's a good idea to keep count. We knew that we put five here. I only have four. One, two, three, four. So I know I have to have a fifth there. So yarn over, find that V. There we go. One, you're going to put two double crochets in that fifth space though. Two. Perfect. So here is what the pattern is going to continuously look like for the rest of this shawl. You're going to chain two, turn, you're going to single or double crochet in the back loops only in each space all the way down until you get to that chain two spot. Okay, then on the other side, you're going to double crochet in the back loop only all the way up until you hit that last one, and then you're gonna put two double crochets in the last one. Okay, so let's do that together. Yarn over, back loop only, one, back loop, two, three, four, five, six, seven, and eight. Just following every stitch, the very top of it, back loop only, is going to get another stitch. Okay, in the corner it's going to be double crochet, triple crochet, two chains, treble crochet, double crochet. So double, treble, chain two, treble, and double. Okay, then just double crochet, back loop only, all the way over. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, and eight. Put two in that last one. Pretty awesome. Chain two, and you just keep repeating this process. So the chain two counts as the first double crochet, because each ending space gets two double crochets. So one more in that end. Then each space down the row will get one double crochet in the back loop. And each middle piece will get a double, treble, chain two, treble, double. And then following one double crochet in each space back up, back loop only. In the last space, you put two double crochets. That's it, guys. That's the continuing pattern that we just repeat row after row after row until you've reached the length that you want your shawl to be. That's it. Pretty easy, which is fantastic. And it's beautiful. And it's comfortable. It's just the perfect shawl, especially for a beginner. If you're not counting, if you don't want to count, it's pretty easy to realize if you've missed one, because if I stopped right there and I go to turn, I'd be like, why is my shawl going downwards and not staying flat? That doesn't make any sense. I don't understand why it's doing that. So you could always just turn and realize, uh-oh, it's going down. Or you could also keep count and be like, okay, so there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. You're gonna have to separate those sometimes to really see them. So there's 11. And I have one, so above this space right here, I got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I do not have the same number. I didn't put one there. There we go. And we put two in that last space. Okay, so keep in mind to count if you are not one to easily identify that, oh, I turned too soon. Otherwise, if you just follow your work, just eyeball it, see that it is staying in line. This is one of those projects that you can easily do without counting. Well, very cool. So that is how you make your shawl. You just keep repeating that process over and over until you've reached the length that you desire. Now let's make the fringe. So grab your ruler or your tape measure or whatever you are going to use. You're going to cut your fringe yarn. So this is my fringe yarn. 12 inches long. So I start there. Go 12, perfect. Cut that off. Great, So each fringe will have 20 12-inch long strands. Okay, so go ahead and cut 20 12-inch long strands and put it into one row. Cut another 20 12-inch long strands and put it in a second row. And another 20 12-inch strands in a third row. We want three different sections because I'm going to put a fringe on each one of the three points. Okay? So go ahead and cut, and I will see you as soon as you're done cutting. All right, so let's just say that you have reached the end of your shawl. You're super happy with it. What do? Come to the very end. You cut off just a small tail. You're gonna take your yarn. You're gonna yarn over, pull it through, pull it tight, and you've just made a knot. Pretty awesome, right? Gonna take that fringe that we just made. I'm just using one for an example, but you'll have three piles, one pile for each corner of your shawl. So you take your yarn, put your finger in about the middle of it. You can put side by side, measure them up, make sure that they seem pretty even. Take your yarn hook. I'm gonna go in this corner right here, the bottom of the shawl. So coming from the back forward, grab your yarn, pull it through that hole, give it a good gap, and then I'm going to remove the yarn hook. I'm going to put my fingers right in there. I'm gonna grab that yarn and just pull it through. And when you pull that yarn, tightens the knot like that. And then I will go and I will tighten each string until it's exactly how I want. If you find that it's not exactly how you want it, it's a little sloppy, just put your hook. So I just put my hook on the bottom, followed it up. Go to the back where it'll look like this, and you can pull these sides just like that, and it loosens it. And then you can go back and be like, okay, I really want to position this maybe like that, more, pull it however you need. But that is how you put the fringe on, and it looks absolutely stunning when it's all complete. Okay, now let's go ahead and put in those ends. So when you weave in your ends, I will go from the back forward, and you usually want to follow the color. I don't have much of a color change, but obviously in my yarn there's a lot of color change. And I don't want to put one color over the other because then it'll stick out like a sore thumb. But you will just weave in that end back and forth. So forward, next space, pull it backwards. Next space, pull it forwards. All right, until it's gotten to either a spot where you need it to stop, or it's gotten to a spot where you can't weave it in and out anymore. I like to cut my yarn the length of the next space. Okay, so I'm gonna cut it right there. So there's just enough of a nub of a piece of yarn to lay flat over the next stitch. I'm gonna grab my fabric glue. Now this is super important. You need to make sure that you buy fabric glue that says it'll dry clear and flexibly. The flexible is super important. I have used fabric glue that did not dry flexibly, and the glue dried rock hard and it just ruined the project. So just be mindful of that. You only need the smallest little bit. And then you lay it flat over the work and just make sure it is secure and not going anywhere. Now, fabric glue is machine wash and dryable, meaning once it dries, that is staying put. It's not going to come out even if you put it in the washer and dryer. It's not separating at all, okay? But when it dries, it'll also dry that flexible. It'll dry clear so you don't even see it. It is perfect. I love this stuff. So let's go ahead and get rid of this tail right here. I'm gonna go in this direction because the color matches a little better. If I went in that direction, it'd be like, whoa, okay, there's a different color over there. What's it doing over here? And just weaving in and out, back and forth. All right, here we go. So, gonna grab our scissors. I'm gonna bring the yarn back up this way so it matches the color. There's a color match. Okay, take your fabric glue just a little bit. Looks like my glue is kind of exploding out of the top a little. Cap that. And just kind of pet it forward. There we go. That's it. And then it looks perfect. It looks complete. And it's beautiful. Oh my gosh, guys, it's so pretty. Yay. Ah, love it. Can't wait for you to do this. So what did you think? I hope you had a lot of fun learning this shawl tutorial. I found that it was very easy and it could make up really quickly, which I was very grateful for because I had to make this shawl very quickly to have it done in time for this tutorial. But I also found that this project was one that you could slow down and take it easy. Pull this project out while watching a movie or a TV show and really relax and de-stress and just go. You don't have to worry about counting. You don't have to worry about following any particular pattern other than just knowing, hey, I gotta do a double crochet back loop only, add two on the ends, and in the middle it's just double, treble, chain two, treble, double. It's the same thing over and over and over, and once you have repeated yourself enough times, you just don't even think about it anymore. And sometimes those projects are so great. So I really hope that you enjoyed learning this crochet pattern. I hope that you had fun. If you did, please give me a like. If you haven't yet, make sure you subscribe to my channel. I have so many videos to show you, and they include how-to videos, how to sell your crochet, how to manipulate a pattern to make it more customized to you, and also what materials work best with which projects. I have so many more videos that I can't wait for you to see, so make sure you subscribe so you don't miss anything. Well, my name is Tiffany Hansen, and I will see you with my next video. Bye.